Good morning, students. Today's our subject is goods and service tax, and the topic is introduction. GST is the goods and service tax. It is a comprehensive tax levy on manufacture, sale, and consumption of goods and services at a national level. When we consume the goods, manufacture the goods, and sell the goods and services at a national level, we have to pay the tax. We have to pay the tax liability. GST is the tax on goods and services with value addition at each stage. So GST is that tax on goods and services which we add the some value at each stage of the manufacturing and sale of the goods. GST will include many state and central level indirect taxes. So in the GST, it includes many states and central level of indirect taxes. It overcomes drawback for present tax system. It also overcomes the drawback of the present tax system, the tax cascading system. Tax structure in India, the direct tax and the indirect tax. These are two taxes are charged on the income. The direct tax is charged on directly on income tax, corporate tax and the wealth tax. And the indirect taxes are charged on excise duty, the custom duty, the service tax and the octroi and VAT. So these are all the types of the indirect taxes. Now come to the methods of taxation. Progressive tax, regressive and proportional tax. The progressive tax, it is the increase of tax for increasing the value of volume. This is the tax when we increasing the rate of the taxes. Because we have increasing the value or volume of the taxes on the size of the business. In the progressive tax system, a progressive tax is the one where the average tax burden increases with the income. It is the high income families pay the disproportionate share on the tax burden, while low and middle class income taxpayers should shoulder a relatively small burden. So this is all about the progressive tax. Now come to the regressive tax. Decreasing rate of tax for increasing the value of volume. A regressive tax is a tax if applied uniformly, taking a larger percentage of income from low income earners than the higher income earners. Now come to the proportional tax. It is a fixed rate of tax for every level of income and production. In the proportional tax, it is the income tax system that levies the same percentage tax to everyone regardless of income. A proportional tax is the same for low, middle and high income taxpayer. Proportional tax are the sometimes referred to as the flat tax. Low income earners are taxed at the lower rate and the high income earners are the taxed at the higher rates. So this is all about the methods of taxation. So now we start with the shortcomings in current tax system. So first is the cascading system. So tax cascading. The tax cascading effect, it is also termed as the tax on tax. This effect occurs when a good is taxed on every stage of the production, such as goods is taxed till it is finally sold to the consumer. This means each succeeding transfer of good is taxed, including of taxes charged on the percentage preceding the transfer. So now come to the complexity. Before the GST, the manufacturers, the sale and the consumptions who consume the goods and services, they face so many complexities because the cascading effect of the taxes. After introducing the GST, the tax burden may be reduced or it may be easier. Taxation at manufacturing level, suppose a person start a business with the semi-finished goods or sometimes they buy a raw material from other person, they have to charge or they have to pay the tax on that raw material after making the goods and the in the form of semi finished goods, he also paid the some kind of taxes when he sell the goods to another person. So this is the taxation at manufacturing level. Each person has to pay the tax at every level of the manufacturing and every level of the sale of the product. So exclusion of services. In GST, the goods and service tax, there are many kinds of services which are excluded from the GST. Some services are excluded from the GST. Tax evasion. The tax evasion is like that. When a person is avoid to pay the tax to reduce the tax burden, the tax evasion is a illegal action in which an individual or a company to avoid paying tax liability. It involving hiding or false income without proof or inflating deductions, not reporting cash transactions. The tax evasion is a serious offense, comes under the criminal charges and substantial penalties. The tax evasion is an illegal action which is done by the individual or the company because to avoiding paying the tax liability or to reducing the tax liability. Sometime due to shift of the burden to pay the tax, a person is hiding the tax or person is he does not show the tax liability. So that's why he is taking the serious offense, comes under the criminal charges and the substantial penalty. Corruption. Corruption, it is a dishonesty and a criminal offense which is undertaken by a person or an organization which is entrusted with the position of authority in order to acquire illicit benefit or abuse for the one's private gain. So this is also the shortcomings in the current tax system to introduce with the GST. So this is the cascading effect of present tax system. This is an example of the tax cascading system. So there is a producer or manufacturer. This is the cost of input, value of input, output, tax rate, selling price including tax rate, and the tax burden. Suppose there is a producer A. He produces the goods and cost of input and the value for output is rupees 100 and the tax rate on tax rate will be charged on the value of output is rupees 10% and the selling price including the tax rate when we charge 10% on 100, this is the 110 and the tax burden is rupees 10. So he shall be liable to pay tax on value of output 100 is 10. Now come to producer B. He purchases the goods from producer A at rupees 110 and the value of output is 150. The tax rate is 10% is applicable on this value of output. When we applicable 10% tax rate on 150, this is the 165. The selling price include tax rate. Now the tax burden will increase the rupees 15. So when producer C comes into the market and he purchases the goods from the producer B and he tries to convert the semi-finished goods into the finished goods, the cost of input for the producer C is the 165 and the value of output is rupees 200 and the tax rate is applicable on the value of output is 10%. So the selling price including the tax rate is 220 rupees. The tax burden is rupees 20 for the producer C. So as you can see in the picture, the tax burden is increasing after producer to producer. So this is the tax cascading system. The tax on tax will be charged by the government. Now come to the VAT. This is the value added tax. It is implemented in the April 1st, 2005. It is a replacement to complex sales tax and it overcomes the cascading effect of the tax. It applied on the value addition portion in the sale price. So VAT is the it is a value added tax system. When we added the value from the goods. It is also known as the indirect taxes and the consumption tax levied on any value of that is added to a product. These are considered indirect taxes since the tax is levied on the commodities and services before they reach the consumer, but ultimately paid by the consumer as the part of the market price before being the paid to the government. So this is the indirect tax. VAT and GST are the non-US consumption tax imposed on sales of goods and by the businesses at the each stage of the production and the distribution. The term businesses include any activity carried on, whether for the profit or not for profit. It, that involves or is intended to involve the sale of the property or the services. VAT and GST also imposed of sale of services as they are rendered. And the VAT is the tax on consumer expenditure and in the theory should not fall in the business activities. The compliance is governed by the regulation of the country where as the conference is held regardless of the if the registration fees are collected by the US. So this is all about the value added services or the value added taxes. Now come to the illustration of the VAT. This example is also we discussed in the earlier slide, the cascading effect of the tax system. In the previous example, value added by V is only rupees 50, that is 150 to 100. Now, tax on producer B would be liable to pay only rupees 5, and that is 10% of the rupees 50, while the tax paid in previous system was rupees 15 and the 10% of the rupees 150. In the older tax system, consumer has to pay rupees 220, but in the VAT system, consumer actually had to pay the rupees 205. Now come to the problems with VAT. It is not uniform in nature. VAT is different for different state, VAT, different rate of taxation for the different goods. So there are another problems with the VAT. As the VAT is based on the full billing system, VAT implementation is expensive. It is not a simple task to calculate value added in every stage, and it is not an easy task. VAT is a regressive in nature, and all the purchases of sales records should be maintained, which will cause increased by the compliance. So raising the VAT will have the negative effect on the productivity growth. Increasing its rate reduces the economic incentive to trade and therefore hampers the division of the labor and the associated productivity gains for increased specialization, economies of scale, and so on. So these are the problems which arise with the VAT. Now, taxonomy of Indian taxation. The VAT and the sales tax are applicable on the sale of goods other than newspapers. When we sale off the goods and services, but other than the newspaper, the VAT and sales taxes are applicable on that goods. The stamp duty, other than 10 specified instruments, the stamp duty is applicable. Tax on agricultural income, toll tax on utilities, and the other taxes. The other taxes are applicable on the land and buildings, entries of goods in local areas, and entry tax. The consumption or sale of electricity, the vehicles, luxuries, including taxes on entertainment, betting, and gambling, alcoholic liquor, narcotic drugs, and opium. Now, what is the GST? It is a comprehensive value added tax on the goods and services. It is collected on value added at each stage of the sale and purchase of the supply chain. Non-differentiation goods between goods and services as GST is levied at each stage in the supply chain. Seamless Input tax credit throughout the supply chain at all the stage of the production and distribution taxes are applicable, and a pass through the taxes is borne by the final consumer. All sectors are taxes with the very few exceptions and exemptions. So this is the history of the GST. Feb 2006, first time introduced concept of GST and announced the date it is the implementation in 2010. Jan 2007, the first GST studied by the ASSOCHAM released by the Doctor's Com. Feb 2007, the FM announced introduction of GST from the 1st April 2010 in budget. The government came out with the first discussion paper on GST in November 2009, but they introduced the 115th constitution.
हेलो
introduced the 115th Constitution Amendment Bill in the year of 2011. Now come to the model of GST. The GST structure, the center GST, state GST, dual GST. The center GST is levied by the, levied to be the government, central government. GST to be levied by the state government, and the dual GST. GST is to be levied by the central and the state concurrently. So this is known as the dual GST. Proposed rate for GST, the items, the total GST rate and the center and the state rate. Goods, the total GST rate is 20%. The center is, and the state, the total GST rate is 20 and the center is 12, state is 8. The services is 16. And the center is by 8% and the state is the 8% rate of tax levied by the GST. Essential goods, the total GST rate is 12%. The center is 6 and the state is 6% and the state GST rate is the 6%. Presently, it is the 26.5%. The cent VAT is 14% and the state VAT is the 12.5%. So this is also these are all the proposed rate of the GST. Taxes proposed to be subsumed in the GST. In the central tax, the excise duty, additional excise duty under Medicinal and Toilet Preparation Act, service tax, additional custom duty, commonly known as the countervailing duty, the CVD, special additional duty, the SAD, SAD, surcharge, and the cent VAT. These are also subsumed in the central tax. The taxes proposed to be subsumed in the state taxes, the VAT, value added taxes, entertainment tax levied by the state, luxury tax, tax on lottery, betting and gambling, entry tax other than for local bodies, that is octroi. These are also, these taxes are also subsumed in the state taxes. So product excluded from GST, which are the products that excluded from the GST, but in these products, the rate of the tax is levied as per the prior instructions. The petroleum product, the alcoholic product, and the tobacco product, these are the three products are exempted from the GST. So now come to the illustration of the GST product A, the VAT system, and the GST system. So this is the comparison under the VAT system and under the GST system, which rates are applicable and what rate of the product are paying and applicable on the goods. This is the base price, 100 and the 100. Both the base price is both the same in the VAT system and the GST of the product. So the 12% excise duty will be levied under the VAT system, but under the GST system, this is not applicable. Plus 12.5%, the VAT is also applicable on VAT under the VAT system. But in GST system, this is the not applicable. State GST, this is not applicable under the VAT system. But in GST system, the rate is 8% applicable on the GST system. The center GST, the under the VAT system, this is not applicable under the VAT system, But under the GST system, the rate of GST, central GST is 12% is applicable under the GST system. Now come to the calculate the total tax burden. Under the VAT system, when we calculate the total tax burden, this is the 26. And when we calculate under the GST system, the total tax burden is the 20. So that's why GST will be introduced in the economy to reduce the tax system and the tax burdens on the consumer. So value of product to consumer in VAT system in 126 rupees and the GST system is 120 rupees. Why does India need GST? So that was the example. The India need GST to reduce the tax burden. GST is being introduced majorly due to tourism. The current indirect tax tax structure is full of uncertainties due to multiple rates. Due to multiple rates, there are multiple forms, the GST and the tax complexity in the prevailing tax regime. So that's why India does need the GST. GST Council, GST levied will be administered by the Union Finance Minister. So the Union Finance Minister Chairman will be GST levy will be administered by these persons. So Union Minister in charge of State Revenue or Finance, Minister in charge of Finance or Taxation, any other Minister, Finance Minister of the state nominated by the each state government would constitute the council. Dispute Settlement Authority. Dispute between the state and center will be handled by the DSA. So this is the authority, those who handle the disputes between the state and center. Appeal from the DSA would be deal with Supreme Court. Example, if a state receives less revenue in comparison with its previous plan, it can appeal the case of the DSA. Importance of Article 246A. There is an assistance by the SG and as VAT in the main source of the revenue for the SG, the state government. In 246, Article 246A, certain powers are allocated to the state governments. The parliament and the legislature of every state will have the power to make law with respect to goods and service tax imposed by the union government or by the state. Benefits of the GST, this is a transparent tax system, uniform tax system across India. Everybody has to follow the same tax system and reduces the tax evasion. This is also have to reduce the tax evasion and tax burdens on the consumer. Export will be more competitive. In with the introduction of the GST, the export will be more competitive. Hurdles in implementation. So there are some hurdles when they started and when they introduced the GST in India. Some kind of disputed arises in the India between the tax between the center and the state to sharing the tax over the tax. Dispute between the center and state over the tax sharing, highly sophisticated IT infrastructure required. Issuing of taxing e-commerce is to be appropriately addressed and integrated. Political imbalance. So GST global scenario. What was the GST global scenario? More than 140 countries have already introduced GST and national VAT. France was the first country to introduce GST system in 1954. And typically it is a single rate system, but two or three rate system also prevents. Canada and Brazil alone have the dual VAT. Standard GST rate in most countries ranges between the 15 to 20%. So India's GST structure is complex, says IMF. The IMF is the International Monetary Fund. The report says to be proposed the GST structure will be required to the center and coordinate with the 30 states, which is as administrative challenges. Even as the International Monetary Fund says, the proposed goods and services will improve the tax compile and enhance the economic growth by 1 to 1.5% over the time. And it finds the structure of the indirect tax system regime in India complex. The GST design being contemplated is fairly complex. It is fairly complex. It is the transparent system with a dual administration arrangement that involves the tax authorities of both and central and state separately taxing a single transaction, says the fund in a report on India. So advantages of the GST as a developing country, India needs a transparent and unambiguous tax structure. A complex tax structure with multiple rate of taxes, multiple taxes across the supply chain. So it is a multiple taxes across the supply chain, and everybody has to follow the same or the uniform system of the tax. High transaction cost in the hands of taxpayer, increased tax collection, wider tax base and the better compliance, improvement in international cost competitiveness, enhancement in efficiency. It also encouraged the unbiased tax structure, helping the weapon against corruption. GST operates on a negative list that all the goods and services are subject to GST unless specially exempted. We all required to pay the GST on the goods and services unless they are specially exempted from the GST. So these are the another advantages, nature of complexities, that the classification to the valuation regarding taxability exists in the present structure. So exists in the present structure. Some of the burning issues are excise on MRP, excise VAT, services on software, VAT and services tax, works contract and right to issues. So proposed key features, dual GST. Dual GST, in dual GST, there are the charge, the central GST tax and the state GST tax. Both the tax are levied for the supply of goods and services. Destination-based tax. So GST is the destination-based tax. Uniform classification. All the consumers and the manufacturers and the sellers have to apply and follow the same rate of the GST. Uniform return challenge in electronic mode. No cascading on central and state taxes. Cross credit between the central and the state are not allowed. The tax levied from production to consumption. This is a global perspective. It has been a part of the tax landscape in Europe for the last 50 years. It is the fastest becoming the preferred form of indirect taxes in the Asia-Pacific region. While countries such as Singapore and New Zealand tax virtually everything is a single rate. So Indonesia have the 5 positive rates, 0 to over the 30 categories of exemption. In China, GST applies only to goods and the provision of repairs, replacement and processing services. It is only recoverable on goods used in the production process, and GST on fixed assets is not recoverable. There is a separate business tax in the form of VAT. Goods and services tax in Brazil. According to Brazil, they were the first country to adopt the GST system. Brazil has adopted a dual GST system, the central and the state, and the rate is the 20%. GST can be adopted. In information network allowing GST Council to cross-check payment, information should be developed. What is needed? It is an IT system like an information tax information network, that is a TIN. Where the TDS or the VAT credit is recorded in the central database, paper bills and sought to be largely eliminated. Knowing more about the GST, we all will have to pay the GST on every product and services when we buy and consume. All indirect taxes are levied by the state and the central will be merged in the one GST. We would exactly know how much the tax we pay, which at the present is difficult to understand. The sellers or services providers collect the tax from their customers. Before depositing the same to the exchequer, they deduct the tax and they have already paid. The success of GST would rest upon the efficiency and equity and simplicity. Thank you.